A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, died no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. And to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourself as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
sometimes his plan makes us laugh, and sometimes we look at him and we go, what in the world are you thinking, right? Don't trust me so much, right? Right, with all of this, I don't know if I can handle all of this. But we can handle everything if we remember that he is on our side and he is there for us every moment of every day, no matter what is going on. And he is there to guide us and to hope for us. And he hopes for us. Our God hopes for us. And he's there, you know, to help us every step of the way. But we also have a job to do as well. We, as we are reminded over and over today, that we are invited into his passion, his death, and his resurrection. Even though there is a pandemic going on, even though there is all kinds of chaos all around us in the world, that stays the same. Our calling stays the same. So, we still have to be priests, we still have to be parents, we still have to be grandparents, we still have to answer our calling every single day. Now, has that been harder? In some ways, yes, it has. It has been harder, and there's been struggles along the way, but we are still called to our calling, to our vocation, and we are still called to proclaim the good news, to continue to give hope to everyone, you know, to bring joy, and to be instruments of God's peace and joy. We are still called to all of that. But we have to go to prayer. We have to calm down. We have to calm down. We have been on high alert since March. Our spirits and our minds and our physical selves are not made to be on high alert for months at a time. We need to bring it down. We need to take more time for prayer. We need to have silent times. We need to turn away from things that are not helping us to calm down. As the reading says today, if there's people in your life that are not helping you to grow closer to Christ, you might need to distance yourself from them. Social distance yourself from them might be necessary. Because they are contaminating you with whatever is bringing you away from the Lord. Probably one of the most common sins or struggles that people are dealing with right now is turning on that TV every night and watching it and allowing it to take our souls and our minds and our peace buried in the ground. And people know that that's a place where they should not be going. Now, of course, it's good to keep up with everything in the world and what's going on, but not for hours a day, right? We have to distance ourselves from all that, right? And we have to continue to look for truth. And not for our truth, guide us every step of the way.
For the Pope, all bishops, priests, and deacons, and all with the whole Church in this time of testing, let us all trust in Jesus' power to lead us to His light after this darkness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Holy Rosary Parish, blessed are You, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. For by Your mercy we have been reborn to a living hope through the resurrection of Christ Jesus from the dead. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole Church, You made us in Your image and renewed us in Christ. Mold us into the likeness of Your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pour out Your love through the Holy Spirit. Heal all hearts wounded by hatred and jealousy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Today, grant work to laborers, grant to the hungry, joy to the sorrowful, grace and redemption to all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may they honestly and tirelessly work for justice, equity, and peace to all persons. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers we hold in our hearts, let us offer them in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, help us to be available to Your guidance and to Your voice in our lives. And we ask all of our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is our God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Sing my name.
the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Our world, to our
Never permit me to be separated from you.
smoke signal, I don't know. It's been sent out a lot, so make sure to vote for that, and it'll be up until July the 1st, I believe. So make sure to vote. Also, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Mai and Carlos for helping us out through all the masses and the prayer and talking to the youth and to the young adults and to all the other things that you have done for putting up with Father Warren for 4 weeks. And that's a testament to your vocation right there. And so we pray for you as you go to St. Mary's. And we will be thinking about you. And I told them that after this is all over, we'll have to invite them back so that we can hug them and shake their hands and all that kind of stuff and actually talk to you in person up close. So let's give them a round of applause.
Found on your worship aid.